And welcome back to Close Up, everyone. From Rand Paul, Bernie Sanders, George Pataki, Chris Christie, now Martin O'Malley, no shortage of visitors to the Granite State in the coming weeks as presidential hopefuls begin to test the waters here in the Granite State. And to talk about it this morning, about the fields that are forming and the issues that may define 2015 and 2016, Republican Party Chair Jennifer Horn and Democratic Party Chair Ray Buckley. Great to see you guys. Thanks for joining us. Jennifer, we'll start with you, and sure. Because you have a lot of buzz right now, especially with Mitt Romney bringing his name back, and he's looking at this pretty seriously. What do you think about this field that's forming?
Well, I think it's an exciting field. It's a diverse field that represents a full spectrum of Republican activists and Republican principles. A number of very qualified, highly qualified folks in the race. We're excited. I think there's going to be a lot of energy in New Hampshire in the Republican Party this year. A lot of attention on the ongoing debate and conversation as it grows. I think it's good for the party. I think it's good for New Hampshire.
Some might say that, you know, there's too many big names though in this field right now with Jeb Bush, Mitt Romney, Chris Christie, Rand Paul. I mean, right. You know, they wind up splitting everything up.
But too many qualified people? I don't think so. I think it's good. I think it's going to be fascinating, certainly, to see how it unfolds. And as these folks start to come to the state and share their ideas and their vision for the future of our nation, I think it's good to have more voices and more ideas in the conversation. I think it's good for the process.
Mm. All right, Ray, Chairman Buckley, Martin O'Malley's coming in March for St. Patrick's Day, governor of Maryland, and Bernie Sanders has been here a couple of times, but largely it's all been, people think it's all eggs in one basket waiting for Hillary to come. For a party, how nice is it to hear from some other voices in the Democratic Party, though, especially here in New Hampshire?
Well, it's important to win in the general election, but certainly in New Hampshire, whoever's chair of either party, we very much take the responsibility of being the host of the primary. We welcome the candidates of all sides. One of the things that's happened in the recent decades that's troubling is that candidates drop out before they even get to the polls here in New Hampshire, whether it was right after Iowa or even in the fall and summer. And I just remind folks when I'm talking to them, it's like, you know, when Bill Sheen and I were out there going door to door for Jimmy Carter in September of 1975, Jimmy Carter was in single digits. He was at 2-3%. He ended up winning New Hampshire with 24% of the vote. Mm-hmm. With this size of crowd on the Republican side, it might take considerably less than that to win the New Hampshire primary. So I would encourage all the folks to stay in, be part of it, and really work hard. That there's an audience for whatever your rhetoric is.
Well, I see you take your party chair hat off for a second, more of a Democratic analyst, though. Do you think that the Hillary Clinton factor is keeping people from testing the waters too much and possibly alienating a lot of support that she's already had?
Well, you know, the secretary has the advantage of not having to announce because there is not another announced candidate. If there was somebody else that had announced that they were in and jumped in, I'm sure that would put pressure on her to jump in. But certainly keeping the focus, keeping the attention on the Republican side is helpful to her if she does decide to run.
What do you think the issues are going to be in 2015? We've heard a lot, Jen, about particularly about, you know, foreign policy.
Right.
I think that's going to wind up being some of the defining.
No question about it. There's no question about it. I think what we've seen over these last 2 years is that the failures of the policies of this president and Democratic leadership are really starting to come home to roost. People are feeling it and living with it, and it's not just health care. It is foreign policy. It's jobs. It's a lot of issues. So I think it's going to be those, you know, kind of those kitchen table issues. Do you feel safe? Do you feel secure? Can you pay your bills? Are you able to educate your children? I think it's the kind of those same core issues that people always care about on election day.
Chairman Buckley.
Well, I agree that it's all going to be those issues, but it's going to be in favor of the Democrats. The president's popularity is now above 50% for the first time since 2009.
Where's that? Nationally?
Nationally.
Okay.
And certainly the economy is rebounding. Obamacare is working. The Medicaid expansion that the Republicans worked with Governor Hassan, we've got over 30,000 New Hampshireites are now insured because of that. Our unemployment here in New Hampshire is just about 4% and falling. So things are really looking up for Democrats. We're feeling that this is going to be a strong election year for us, as it has been in the last 20-some-odd years in the presidential year.
And we'll see what happens, but everybody likes to look ahead also to the 2016 general election and the Senate race that's here, which could essentially be Kelly Ayotte versus Governor Maggie Hassan. I know that you guys probably don't want to weigh in too much on that sort of thing, but that could really extend the political season here in New Hampshire, because we're already into the primary season, and that's just going to take us all the way to the general election. Your thoughts?
Oh, absolutely. It's an important race, and I think the people of New Hampshire have been very happy with Senator Ayotte, and she's brought a strong, independent voice. She's fought for the people of New Hampshire and Washington, and making sure that, you know, she has the resources and the support that she needs to be successful in the next general election is going to be a priority for the Republican Party in New Hampshire.
Your thoughts on a potential Senate race with Kelly Ayotte and whoever it may be?
Well, in the past 20 years, Republicans have only won a statewide office in a presidential year twice, and that was Bob Smith in 1996 and Judd Gregg in 2004. We think this is going to be a very competitive race. A lot of people nationally are looking at that. And even if Governor Hassan takes a pass on it, we've got a long list of people that will be a very serious candidate, and we think we'll be successful.
You've had success in getting the vote out the last two cycles, but is this a playbook that needs to evolve to a degree, heading into an open seat in the White House? And
every election is different. We obviously watch very closely on what the Republicans are doing here in New Hampshire, and we try to do it twice as good, and it seems to be working out for us.
What about you? Because a lot of people say this is all about
getting out. I hope his confidence plays well for him going forward. I'm very confident as we move forward. We've made a lot of changes in the last 2 years in our ground game, in the way that we invest our financial resources, our technology, the way that we use data, and we're going to continue to grow on that effort going forward. Continue to expand our voter base as we've done over the last 2 years, and I am confident moving forward that we're going to continue to see expanded success. We were able to win back a significant majority in the House. We increased our majority in the Senate. We won back the Executive Council. Mm-hmm. We won back the seat in the 1st District. And in 2016, it's all about building on that success and expanding those victories.
Again, though, getting back to what a lot of Republicans said post-election in November, is it's Democrats are just better at getting people to the polls. And if you can't outwin them there, you're not going to win any elections. So the national folks in the Republican Party put together a plan, but is it one size fits all, or is there room to maneuver within a system so it works for New Hampshire?
Not at all. It's not at all one size fits all. It's very much state specific. It's very much about the individual communities where the voters are. And no matter what kind of changes you make with technology, data, all those things that we talk about in a ground game, the bottom line is getting folks to vote on Election Day is about talking to voters about the issues they care about, inspiring them to vote for your candidate. It's about getting to where they are and moving them to where you need them to be. And that hasn't changed. That basic formula of what elections are has not changed, and it's never going to.
Well, some Chairman Buckley say that the Democrats are just better at not using the system, maybe manipulating the system, manipulate to get people to the polls. Like here in New Hampshire, everybody's versed.
I'm glad you said it, not me, by the way.
That's what a lot of people characterize it as. Not that there's any wrongdoing or breaking the law, but with our domicile laws the way they are here, same day registration, you guys are just see the opportunity and you're better at taking advantage of it.
Well,
is that fair to say?
Well, we believe that anyone who lives in New Hampshire has the legal right to vote, and we encourage them to exercise that right. And we are also much better. We have a massive legal protection operation that is in almost every poll. We had over 75 lawyers that took Election Day off to make sure that what happened in 2002 in New Hampshire and what happened in 2000 in Florida never happens here in New Hampshire again. And so I really credit the enormous amount of legal team that making sure that voters are allowed to vote in the state of New Hampshire has really made a big difference for us.
The Secretary of State said recently, for the first time, I believe, that he was concerned that the current voter laws in New Hampshire made it ripe for an embarrassing case of fraud. Do you share that concern?
Well, he's backed off from that since then. The reality is that we have the centralized voter system. And so if there was that sort of case, if somebody had registered in one community, went over to another community and registered and voted in both places, the statewide voter registration system at the Secretary of State's office would know that within a matter of weeks. And so far, that has not happened. This law was put into effect starting the 1994 election, and it's worked since then. And a lot of other states have now copied New Hampshire.
Yeah, I'm not aware that the Secretary of State has backed off of that. I think it's a concern that's shared by a lot of Granite Staters, not just the Secretary of State. And I think it's, a question about what is the intention of the law and who, what were the folks who wrote that law intending, was that every resident in our state would have the right to vote and the access to the voting booth. The intention was never that people who do not actually live here would have the ability to vote and impact the outcome of our elections. So I think that you probably will see an effort going forward to look at that law and to figure out where the fine-tuning has to take place.
Sure.
And I think that the Secretary of State was clear when he expressed his concerns about the potential for fraud there.
But there's also a lot of implications that it could have on college students and things mm-hmm. like that. We're just about out of time, but I do want to ask you, General, we'll start with you, about the New Hampshire's place in the process and this our particular sure. opportunity that we have, not by party, but just as a state, the open seat in the White House. People are starting to come here, but in
right.
recent cycles, they wonder, well, do we have to? Do you think this will kind of put us back?
Right. You have to come to New Hampshire. You have to play New Hampshire. What we do in New Hampshire is critical to the process and serves an important an important service to the nation. Our ability to vet the candidates, to that living room campaigning, across the family room campaigning, it can't be lost. It's very important to the process, and I think that it's always going to be preserved here.
Chairman Buckley, last word.
Well, the fact is that we don't actually decide. We just make recommendations, having spent quality time with each of the candidates. And the beauty is that any resident can go to any, if you're a registered Democrat, you can go to a Republican, a house party. If you're a Republican, you can go to a Democratic house party. Anyone is allowed to come and participate and involve, and I think that's something that's very important, not as Mrs. Horn said, not just for the parties, but really for the country.
Indeed. Now, thank you both for being here, and this is going to be an interesting year, no question about it.
Thank you.
And go Patriots, right?
Absolutely.
We can agree on that.